don't like this darkness stuff. Ah! It is a secret passage. What's this? We are here. Whatever this is. That's a lie to Mom and Dad's situation, but it was so worth it. The girls on stage were just so loud and real and awesome, and everyone was moving together like one huge tide of sound. Have you heard that? The Psycho House Girl. The coolest stuff about being the Psycho House Girl. Cool thing number one. Everyone in the hall thinking you don't know they're looking at you and whispering as you walk past because I guess they haven't heard of peripheral stuff. Costumes. Skeletons and devils cheerleaders from the Smells Like Teen Spirit video. One girl dressed as Jackie Kennedy. Bratmobile. Women Outlaws. Oh wow, this is old. May, 10 cents. This'll show you who runs things around this joint. She's tougher than a wild Mustang. No female is gonna tell me. Yag. They sure will. I'm gonna cut out part of it. Heavens to Betsy. Terrorist. A sock. Goodfellow Senior High School. Dear Miss Greenbrier, I appreciate the time and effort you put into writing your letter. It showed initiative and was well written, but it does not change my mind on this matter. While I understand that Mr. Soto is a friend of yours, the fact that the matter is that she defaced school property with profanity. Ooh. The fact that she allegedly defaced her own locker in retaliation for another student doing the same to yours is immaterial. As to your complaint that no other student had been punished for their part in this incident, the fact is that no guilty party has come forward, and there has been no convincing evidence as to who might have defaced your locker. In other words, there is no one to punish. I would suggest letting this issue drop, as it will only bring more unwanted attention on yourself, which I believe is what you claim began this whole incident in the first place. Sincerely, Principal Sheldon Grossman. He's a gross man.
I don't get Lonnie sometimes. Like, her band, and our zine, and her hair, and everything are all anti-authority. But I watch her in JROTC, and she's doing drills in perfect formation. Following orders, no question. And there's all this stuff in the news about don't ask, don't tell. Like, she's going to join the army and then have to lie about who she is? She said they don't need to know what they don't need to know.
Just now.
Like it was no big deal. This from the girl who trashed her locker to, like, defend my honor. I've learned when to stop arguing, though. I don't think Lonnie even gets Lonnie sometimes.
It's a dichotomy in Lonnie, huh? Sonic Youth. Alright, well, I'm still looking around. I haven't found anything of a four-digit code, a second four-digit code. And you can't make multiple saves here, apparently. It looks like that's going to out there. What's in here? Or this goes up there. Oh. This goes to the guest room. Oh, neat. It's a dildo handle. Have I been in here? Right. and I checked that out. Stop that. You know, I don't like that. The thump followed by the squeak thing, I don't like that. Is this where he came from? Yeah. Yes. Still like the Morley cigarettes reference. Very cool. Got some X-Files fans here. Oh, we're in here, so we can work our way back and open that door from the other side. Unlock from the outside. Okay. Cool. So we didn't have to find a key again here. En español. Offer of promotion. Oh, for her mother. Bruce Pendleton. Dear Head Conservationist Greenbrier, due to your exemplary management of the flintlock prescribed burn operation last year and the service's need for experienced personnel to direct regional operations, we would like to offer you the position of Regional Conservation Management Director, responsible for operations throughout northwestern Oregon. Your assistance would be sought to fill your previous position on-site at the Flintlock National Forest. Your new posting would be at the Regional Management Building, located at 128 Bullhorn Road, which should be much more convenient for your daily commute. Please respond as soon as possible regarding your decision. We very much look forward to your reply. Signed, Bruce Pendleton. So she is promoted to regional. Is that why they moved here? Stop that. What's up there? Guardian angels up above bless this house with lots of love. Yeah, do plenty of that. Thank you. Hey Lonnie, sorry my mom was such a bitch last night. She's hardly ever around since her forest is like an hour away, and then when she is home she takes it out on you, like because you're not a member of her family, she knows you won't call her on it, and I'm sorry. Ha, it's okay. I know, she's just jealous of our cool and freewheeling lifestyles. I feel sorry for you. I'm lucky my mom lives in Florida. You have a mom every day. Sorry, I didn't mean to bring up the mom thing like that. I know I shouldn't complain. No, I'm being serious. My mom is a psycho Christian, and her new husband, Don, is a complete tool. Living in Florida with him is her eternal punishment in my mind. So you wouldn't rather live with your mom in Florida? No. Inside Edition. Investigative team visits camp whose specialists help adolescents overcome deviant behavior and homosexuality. Great.
Katie, you know how mom and dad are. Not exactly super open-minded about things. It feels like every minute I don't spend with Lonnie, I spend worrying about them finding out about us. Mm. And what would happen if they did? You know Dad's joke about the nunnery that he'd tell whenever you brought boys around the old house? I wonder where he'd want to send me.
Is that why she's not here? Was she sent off to a nunnery? Of course, doesn't explain where the parents are. Just Earth, Wind, and Fire. February 23rd of 95. That looks spooky. Where am I? Oh, this is the whole wing. Sam, this skull was the coolest thing I found in Mexico, and it was like $3. American. I love it. Merry Christmas. Miss you. P.S. Treasure it always. I leave all lights on. Dining room. She has another purse. Manual for Forestry Research and Education. Hi, Jan. I got 2 tickets for Earth, Wind, and Fire on Thursday, but my girlfriend says she doesn't want to go. Her taste in music rears its ugly head again. So that leaves me with an extra ticket that I thought you might be interested in. More fun than clearing brush in the freezing rain, right? Rich. Oh. That's, Ranger Rick. There's other stuff, though. Move it. I can't look at these. Alright. Linens. Kicking against the patriarchy, the great Goodfellow riot of 95. This one's for you, Grossman. Revolution, issue number 1. This is why she ripped up that comic. Heard enough? Had enough? Ready to join the revolution and take a stand against Grossman and its patriarchy? Yeah, fight back. Captain A. Rev-elution girl. Maybe you just want more cool zines, or maybe even a mixtape. Mixtape. Send us your missives from the Girl Riot Underground. Boone County, Oregon. Disciplinary referral for Samantha. Principal's office. Distributing inappropriate materials on school grounds. Phone call to students' parents. Out of school suspension. April 24th to 25th. Sam, since you refuse to hear us out this afternoon, your mother and I are putting this in writing so that we are absolutely clear. You are grounded from the rest of the month from school and telephone privileges, and from using your car for anything except going to and from school. We understand what you are going through, but we can't allow you to continue with this kind of behavior at school. And clearly, once your privileges are reinstated, we can't allow you to have your bedroom door closed while Lonnie is at the house. No, this is the last word on the matter. Get back on course so this won't have to happen again, Dad. This makes no sense. If she's grounded... Oh, once your privileges are reinstated. So they found out. Why else would they want the door open?
I had an interesting talk with Mom and Dad tonight. One you were never gonna need to have. I mean, you've known, right? I've known. I've known since, like, She-Ra.
She-Ra.
Mom and Dad didn't, I guess. But they saw the zine and the stuff on the locker, and they were like, is there something we should know about you and Lonnie? And so here's the thing. I was prepared for them to be mad, or disappointed, or start crying, or something. But they were just in denial.
The kids?
You're too young to know what you want. You and Lonnie are just good friends. You just haven't met the right boy. It's a phase. That's what I didn't see coming. That they wouldn't even respect me enough to believe me. Well, joke's on them, because they're in for one very long phase.
That's right, girl. Yeah, that sometimes that could be even worse. So how did they get that idea from Azine? I mean, maybe it just seems lesbian-like. On a postcard. I want better lighting for it. Dear Mom, Dad, and Sam, the Vatican is weird. As you can see, the Catholic Church still has a lot of money left over from the Middle Ages. I've gotten to see all of the art, including the Sistine Chapel ceiling and the sculptures by Michelangelo, Donatello, and the rest of the Ninja Turtles. The Mom will have to come back together. I would love to be here with someone who really appreciates the history behind everything. Sorry. Also, Sam, they have various relics, as in pieces of important dead people. So you should probably come too. Next stop, Barcelona. Calm down, Dad. I won't get gored by a bull. Probably. Love, Katie. God. No butts in heaven. Does it look like a butt? Well, that's better. No butts in heaven. Oh, stop. I was just getting comfortable again. See, I didn't want to pick up and look at other things when she was talking. Oh, about in here, before I continue. Linens and stuff. Sometimes it seems no matter how well lit it is in the room, you end up in the shadowy places. So there was something over here somewhere. Wasn't there? Or was it just here? Where was it? I saw something. I just didn't want to pick it up, because maybe it was this? Mountain Mart? Circular. There was something. Where the hell was it? Oh, we'll read this. First off, congratulations! Janice Green by our regional director. And I say congratulations because, come on, you're going to take the job, right? What are you waiting for, an engraved invitation? Call them back. But in the meantime, let's discuss this little outing you had with our favorite flannel-clad hunk. What a blast. But you sound like you're reading a lot into an innocent night out. You sure there's something there? You said he has an out-of-town girlfriend. You sure they're not serious? Okay, do we have to figure out when we'll see each other next in person? Enough with the letters. I owe you a congratulatory margarita, boss lady. Soon, Carol. I didn't open this. I know there was something. The drawer is in my way. There's nothing in here. So loud. Wasn't it on top of here? I don't get it. Or was it this? It was this. The Accidental Warrior. Don't give up on this, honey. By Terrence L. Greenbrier. Now, that might be a reference to Stephen King. Because Stephen King, his first novel, as some of you may know, was Carrie. He wrote the whole thing and threw it in the trash. And his wife, Tabitha King, took it out of the trash. And I think, without even saying anything to him, she sent it to, you know, a publishing house. And they accepted it. So, not completely sure about the end of the story, but I know she grabbed it out of the trash, which is very neat. You know, and if she hadn't done that, who knows, we might never had a Stephen King. He might have decided to be a teacher instead, which he was doing, and they were living in a trailer, something like that. Alright. So that's it. It sounds spooky. Wasn't there another place we didn't go? Let me double check. Is there any delay going off into spooky sounding room? This way. Oh, this connects. Alright, we'll go this way first then. And then we'll exit. I don't know about the safe combination. Hopefully it's nothing really important. Have we been here? Yeah, we came from here, I just didn't go this way. Kitchen. The scary sound was the fridge. Russian dressing. Finley's. Yeah, taste it! I said taste it. Milk. Used by 6595. Cola. What is it? Woman's. Best for your table. I saw something. Stanford's American Sandwich Slices. Imitation pasteurized processed cheese food. Like they really write that on there. Sweet pickle relish. Look. Raspberry jam. Raspberry jam is pretty good. My favorite, strawberry. I want to see what's back there. More milk. 2% milk. What's the date on this? Best before. There's no date! And this is whole? Well, I can't even tell. There's not even a label on it. Ooh, banana. The edge of the banana looked like something standing near me. I'm crazy. I am so crazy, guy. Jesus. Look, now I'm making a mess. Ice cream! Ooh, cookie caramel. It has a lot of crap in it. Since 1983, Sarah's Finest has provided the mouth-watering ice cream your family expects. On its own, or the topping of your choice, Sarah's Finest is dependably excellent. Bloop. Fish sticks! More almonds. More cooking directions. Yeah. No toaster oven instructions. God damn these people. Kernel corn. Miller's. Frozen spinach. This almond's really popular. As people like corn, don't they? I feel bad about making such a mess. I popped it right in there. Imagine I get assaulted by something while I'm trying to... Yeah, I'll put the cheese in there. Why the hell not? Back there. You guys ever go in your fridge and you just can't leave the fridge because it drags like that? I hate that. Yay! Let's stop things from defrosting. Sam's schedule working at Crown Burger on Bethel Road. That's her schedule. Mr. and Mrs. Jonathan Blair request the honor of your presence at the marriage of their daughter Helen Margaret to Mr. Richard Morris Patermack. Oh, so is this, that's Ranger Rick getting married. Sunday the 4th of June 1995 at half past. Sunday the 4th of June. That's really late in the year. I'm not sure what the current date is, but 4th of June. Hold on. Actually. Oh, he escaped. She's headed back on June 6th. This was June 4th. Something happened at this wedding? Bratmobile. Some special? I like how I can, like, just pop things in there instead of using, go, you know, put back. The accidental savior, Terrence Greenbrier. Did it look like that, or is it something right all over it? John Russell knows that the president's life hangs in the balance, but who would believe him? Unknown Dimension Limited. They sent him back his books. They wouldn't sell. Samantha and Daniel were in the woods one day. It was sunny and they were on a adventure, I think. But they went to the what part? Dark part of the woods? Something part of the woods, and it got dark. The dirty? I don't know what that means. Daniel said, "Are you scared?" So Samantha said, "No, are you?" They laughed and went more into the... This is incredible. More into the bad part. Then they went to a part that was never there before, and there was a ship. A pirate ship. On an ocean. Samantha says, "I'll be the captain and you be the first mate." Daniel said, "Aye, captain." And they went on... Aye, captain. And they went on the pirate ship and started sailing away. That's cute.
Daniel finally came over to get his game. I'd been dreading it.
Have you?
But he brought this story with him that I wrote when we were little.
What?
I started reading it. And then there I was, crying at the kitchen table. He asked what was wrong, and I was thinking about how we used to be friends, how much I'd taken for granted. But instead, I told him about school, and Dad, and Lonnie. And then how sorry I was that I wasn't his friend anymore. He gave me a hug and said it was going to be okay. For some reason, I almost believed him.
Aww. Pots. Huh. Lost power at some point. Well, not surprising. Doesn't the power always go on and off over here? Surprised it hasn't happened yet. Dear Regional Conservation Director Greenbrier, having received your formal acceptance letter, I write to congratulate you on your new position as Regional Conservation Director of the State Forestry Service. We wish you Luck in your final weeks at Flintlock National Forest, and very much look forward to welcoming you to your new desk in the State Forestry Office at 8 a.m. on May 1st. $10.95. Do you have a light over here that we can turn on? Yes. Can I look at any of these things? No. There's a something here, though. I can't open that. Or that. Rick's wedding. Anniversary trip. His wedding? Can't make it, send regrets. June 6th. Well, this is why they're not here. They're on their anniversary trip. So we can't make Rick's... Katie comes home this month. We'll call with exact date. I guess I called too late. Forest Loop Trail Hike event. Sam goes to the dentist. Well, where's Sam then? Oh, I can't. I try to, like, go down. Check. Church potluck. Scalloped potatoes. Cushing Elementary Public Areas cleanup. Charity junk pickup. Basement. Noon. So apparently, they're just on their anniversary.